could you break down, Amin, a little bit more about this idea of trading into cap space versus not, and why the salaries don't have to quite match?
Right. It's the issue is, when the deal was consummated, you got these players over here, Ingram and Ball, making their salary, and Anthony Davis's salary, which goes up once 2019-2020 starts, which it already has. So if you have this amount of space right now, you can sign a player, then trade those guys within the reason and bring back Anthony Davis' salary. If you have to do the deal first, Anthony Davis' larger salary then eats up the, which roughly comes out to about $2 or $3 million.
A year.
Yes, and that takes away from the starting salary, which takes away from the raises, which takes away from down the line. It's like a trickle-down effect. And so the thing is, there's two things. One, you could say to New Orleans, to Atlanta, to all the other teams involved in the deal, hey, can you guys wait a little bit? We're still waiting on Kawhi. But they're not going to wait.
Right.
So you have to execute this deal when it's supposed to happen, which is on the 6th, and in which case you're going to have less money in Auburn. You just hope that Kawhi doesn't really care that much about the $11 million.
Well, yeah, and you're right. And by the way, each hour that passes, time is ticking. The 6th is tomorrow. That's Saturday. Yeah. And it is noon Eastern time that these trades can start to get executed. It's the Lakers and Pelicans. But as you note, it's the Hawks. It's the Sixers. It's the Pistons. It's the Grizzlies. It's the Jazz. It's the Wizards involved in all of this. And it's not just Kawhi who would then have to decide if he would take less money from the Lakers. It's any other players, Kendrick, if they don't get Kawhi.
Right.
And then they make up that sort of, you know, that podge pie of who else they might get.
Right.
So if you were Kawhi sitting at home and you're aware of this, is this going to make you speed up your decision to before noon tomorrow, or you're just going to do what you're going to do?
I got to do what I got to do because I'm my own man. Like, at the end of the day, I cannot dictate my future on behalf of another man. It's not called being selfish, but he earned this right. Like, this guy went and won a championship, finals MVP. He got the right to take his time. I mean, this is a big decision for him. Whether it affects whoever, he need to take his time. If the Lakers can't wait, then it up the chances for Toronto, which I think he's going back anyway. I see the 190 on there. He can't pass that up. He can't pass up the five-year 190. Come on, Kawhi.
Kendrick just saw the money. He was like, ooh.
you want to chime in here?
Well, I mean, I think the only person who knows whether or not they feel pressure is Kawhi. But if he does feel that pressure, he is doing an excellent job of resisting it. And that is, the proof is in the pudding in how long he has taken to kind of think about all of those things and weigh all of the things that Amin was just talking about.
The other thing to remember is that $11 million only applies to Kawhi says I'm signing a four-year deal,
right?
If he's deciding to sign a smaller deal, that money difference between them and the Clippers and the Raptors gets smaller and smaller, because the whole thing is that money difference happens over the span of 5 years or 4 years. So if he says, I'm signing a two-year deal anyway, a one plus one or two plus one, then it's not as big of a difference in money.
And the incentive to sign a two-year deal is that if he reaches two more years, he hits that 10-year veteran level, which then will entitle him to more salary afterward. If he signs at the 8-year level, then obviously he wouldn't get as many much salary in those later 2 or 3 years.
And to explain a very important point to people, it's not just the idea that he's going to get 35% of the cap versus 30% of the cap right now. It's also the cap goes up. So it's a bigger slice of a bigger pizza pie.
Right.
So there's a lot of money he's got on the table there.
Before we go to break, I do want you to tell what you told on our earlier show today about his college days and the pace of his making his decision.
So we interviewed Steve Fisher, his college coach, and I asked him, Coach, how did you get him to come here? And he said, I'll be honest with you, if it were up to Kawhi, he'd still be sitting right now trying to figure out what school to go to. He's a very methodical decision maker, deliberate, right? And so we saw a report from Jason Dumas say that when he finally committed to San Diego State, they weren't sure that he'd show up until summer classes started, because he wouldn't communicate with them. He was just gone for weeks on end. So 6 days is nothing in Kawhi time.
I
don't know. I feel the responsibility to tell Kawhi, if you're watching out there, training camp starts like September 28th, depending on the team. So that if you make everyone wait until then, we're going to have some
serious exactly.
I mean, thank you so much for joining
no
us.
No problem.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For highlights and analysis, check out the ESPN app. And for live streaming and premium content, check out ESPN+.